Greetings, brothers and sisters in the motherland. My name is Elijah and welcome to my channel. This is my first audio recording here on YouTube. Now, my goal for this recording is to provide you some background to the project I'm embarking on for my mother in Brong Ahafo region, just about 360 kilometers from Accra. I think that most of the videos I've watched on YouTube are predominantly based in Accra or just a few cities around the area. But I think that it's about time we have some different perspective on building in the middle part or even in the northern part of Ghana where resources might not be as readily available. And so my purpose here is to provide you with that type of insight. I'm building in the Brong Ahafo region, which is in the middle belt of Ghana. And so transportation, materials, and staff life, it might be entirely different. The quality as well as the quantity might be different from what we have in Accra. All right, so by profession, I'm primarily into higher education. I teach and research as a professor in a university. So building and construction is not my area, but I have been fascinated about people building. And so having been away from my country for so many years, I thought it would be good to start a project in Ghana by first building something for my mom. My mom, for those of you who don't know, has retired after teaching in the Ghana Education Service for over 40 years. Now she's living her comfortable life. She prefers to live in Ghana than in the United States. But she'll come and visit. So my purpose here is to make her happy. Now there was a little bit of a struggle initially where to build this house. So as you can see in the video, there is already an old house there. So this is her land that she acquired sometime in the 90s. She built this house. It's about two bedrooms and a living room and a kitchen and all that, right? And so when I told them to build a house for her, she said, well, I have some plots in front of the old house. I said, no way. That area, people are building without planning. The zoning there is very shoddy. It's not good. The street, people are building into the main streets and stuff like this. So I thought maybe we should use some of the land that the family own in some newly developed areas of the city. Techiman, by the way, it's a growing municipality in Ghana, one of the fastest growing because of the market and because it's the hub for those going north and south, east and west. So eventually, suffice it to say that she convinced me to build right there. So the plot size for this entire building, including the old structure at the back, is about 85 by 120 feet. So you see in Ghana, I think the typical land is around 70 by 100. It used to be 100 by 100. So that means this is less than two plots, but just maybe a little bit above a one plot. So you have an idea that we're dealing with a very small space, considering that there was already an old house on the land. So I sat down with the architect on the phone, and we designed this building to economize the space. I think that's one thing in Ghana. People should build up rather than making a poor use of the land, right? We need to build up, make good use of the land, so that you can have a small space, you can still have everything you need. So the house we're building here, and you saw the picture, the architectural design in the front part of the video, you can go back and look at that. This is a 5-bedroom or 6-bedroom house if you include the what my mother would call the worship room or the office room. So at downstairs there is a 1-bedroom en suite, and we have a 2-car garage, the laundry room, storeroom, open concept kitchen, a big living room. Then there was some storage closets over there. Then we have a smaller bathroom separate from the ensuite bathroom for guests at the downstairs. Then when you go upstairs, we have the master bedroom and then 3 other bedrooms. And then we have the office or the worship room and a family area. Another kitchen upstairs, a smaller kitchen, and I think that's about it. All right, so now you can see over here and in this part of the video, we went a different route than mostly some of the approaches to building in Ghana. So this contractor decided to build the columns, the pillars, reinforced concrete pillars, and rather than doing the block work for the ground floor, he decided to do the top beams, the top concrete floor. And so you see the woodwork with the bamboo and other things as they are trying to build the structure. I was not a fan of this approach, but later on I thought, I mean, these pillars are strong, so the positive side is looking at how heavy and how big these pillars are. They're going to give the building a very strong foundation. But later on I realized that the measurement for the pillars are bigger than the normal block size in Ghana. So you can see that creates a challenge, because the typical block size in Ghana is about, I think, 5 or 6 inches in terms of the width, if I'm right. If I'm not right, correct me. And so the pillar sizes, I think the measurement is about 9 inches or so. So even if you're using the bigger size of block, which is about say 5 or 6 inches, you still have about 3 or 4 inches of pillar left uncovered. So those of you who have had this similar problem, please share your thoughts in the comment section. I want to know how to deal with it. So one solution to that was asking them to flush the block work, you know, outside, so that when you're outside looking out of the building, everything lines up, and then the excess inches of the pillar will go inside. Now maybe we'll deal with that later on with some plasterboard rather than mortar, and kind of seal the entire and hide all these, or maybe we will use that as a design. But it's creating some challenges because the plumbers are telling me the pillars are very solid, the concrete and chiseling, you know, through to pass the pipes, the green pipes and stuff like that can be difficult. But for your FYI, that's for your information, this project began in the fall, or let's say late summer of 2019. It's 2019, and right now we are at the roofing stage. We've finished the roofing, and you know, we are getting to the fence wall, burglar proofs have been constructed or fabricated. Windows, we're working on that. Electrician is chiseling and putting in conduit boxes. And, you know, so the project is ongoing, and my plan is to get this completed in the next year or two, God willing. So I want to point, if you make a few points, where you see here, you know, in the video, you say that the iron rods have been put up there, the plumber and the electrician will come and do their work, you know, before they put the cement, the mortar, the concrete, I apologize, in here. Now, I want to shout out to a few YouTubers who have inspired me. Again, as I said, I am a very busy man because of my profession, but I've been supervising this. The last time I was in Ghana was in 2018, and the project began in 2019, and I have not been home, so I haven't seen anything. Just supervising through video recordings and WhatsApp, so you can see it's very frustrating. And I want to shout out to Forever Homes, one of the pioneers in building in Ghana. I watch most of your videos. I want to also shout out to the Only Way in Ghana, another pioneer. Ashanti Queen. And we have Natural Ghana Girl. And my own brother and friend, Rastani Jini, I hope I pronounced that well. That's Ouswajiman retirement home in Tema. The Quashes, Asha and Gad, Bright and Clara. I want to stop you before I forget to mention some names, because I'm watching all of you from the United States, and you're doing a great job. You know, that's what YouTube is for. As a growing civilization, we live in a 21st century where technology has reached a point that people can learn from their homes. So it bridges the information asymmetry so that people are not lording information over others, which by sharing information with the knowledge, we have power. And I think that you are doing a good work. And I want to shout out to Mr. Ayevi or something like that in Togo, building in Togo. You are so very helpful. So thank you, sir. So you can see the electrician has done his work. The plumber has done his work as well. And the next step will be pouring in the concrete, right, to complete the process. All right, before they start the block work. So I'm going to keep this recording short. It's within 15 minutes or so, and the next steps will be communicated in the subsequent recordings. I've done a lot of things that might be helpful to some of you in terms of buying the roofing sheets and other things from outside Ghana, because of the quality I was looking for. And it's not difficult. You can do that. And I cut the price or the cost by a lot by doing that, rather than buying the local materials. Another point I want to make is that supervising a project from the diaspora, it's very difficult and frustrating. And I think Asher and Guide and other people have mentioned that, all right? And it leads to a lot of wastage, because sometimes, because of the time difference, the contractor would have done part of the project, and I'm watching the video later in the night in the United States, and then I will have to make corrections, and that leads to a lot of wastage. But overall, I'm very pleased with how things have turned out. My plan is to transform the entire area. So the older building with a rusted roof will go away. We'll get some bulldozers and caterpillars to erase that building and use that back space for a swimming pool or summer hut. And so I'm getting to the end of the recording. You can see that the concrete has been poured and everything looks great. So the next step is to begin the block work. I also want to transform the area by building a fence wall and then getting the streets all leveled. Hopefully the neighbors will help to get that done. But again, thank you for checking my channel, and God bless. See you.